Hello, this is a demonstration of beta software that we have been working on TMS software, which is about embedding the web form designer, the same web form designer that we are using on Visual Studio Code inside RAD Studio. So you will get all the benefits of working with web technologies inside your existing IDE, okay? So I'm going to be creating a new TMS Web Core application, okay? And now the web form designer, initially, if you see it, it will look exactly the same as the VCL form designer. So if you right click, you will notice that this pop-up menu looks different. Okay, so this is a way for you to know that you are using the web form designer, and you can exactly work in the same way. So you can drop your components there, and you can double click in order to create an event handler, you know, everything as usual. So what makes this web form designer so special? That, for example, you can make modifications on the HTML, and you can add, for example, my style, and you can add, for example, background color red, okay? And now when you switch to the design time, you have the element class name drop down, you can select it. And now you have that style applied to the control, and you can see exactly what you are going to get when you run your application. Okay, so you can make any changes and say yellow, for example, switch back to design, then you get your style applied. And you can, for example, I think it's border radius, I don't know, 5 pixels. Okay, so you switch to design. I'm going to add more, a bit more. Okay. You switch to design, and then you see your change. Okay. So you can benefit from using that, and you can use different controls at the same time, and that the style will be applied. The same if you add bootstrap or anything. Okay. So now what we are going to do is to add a more complex sample. For example, we are going to include an image. Here, you can also edit the body of the HTML, and I'm going to be adding image, initially no source, width is going to be 600, okay? So you get this, is the image in the background, and you have your buttons on top of it, okay? And this is because, of course, there is no image on the source. So we are going to go to Google, for example. Okay, I'm going to be copying this image link, and then I'm going to edit on the source, paste it here, switch back to design time. Okay, so here we have our Google image, exactly as expected. Okay, now we are going to do another example, for example, HTML5 template. We are going to this site, for example. We are going to search for one that works for us. I'm going to use this one and to download it. Okay. And to uncompress it. This one or. Or this one, I'm going to be using this one. So this is the right one, I'm going to be extracting it. Okay, so this is with all the assets and so on. I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code to open that folder so I can see the contents. This is the right folder. I'm going to be closing stuff here that I don't need. Okay. So let me check about this. So this is the index HTML. Okay. And what I'm going to do is to copy all this HTML. I'm going to be pasting it on the unit HTML directly. Okay. To see what happens. switch back to design time. Okay, and now what I'm getting is my buttons as expected and all the HTML in the background, but there are no images style whatsoever because the folders that contains all the assets are not located on the folder where this project lives. Okay, so I'm going to be saving this project. I'm going to be using, let's see here, demo 2, for example, to be saving it. Save everything. Okay. I'm going to show this into the Explorer. And I'm going to be here. So I'm going to copy the images and assets folders into the folder where my application lives. Okay. So paste in there. And now what I'm going to do is to switch back and forth between HTML and design. Okay. So this is the powerful or the power or of the web form designer in the sense that whatever HTML, CSS, JavaScript, anything that is web related is shown live on the web form designer. Okay. So you can, for example, this is a responsive design. Okay. That works perfectly well and coexists. This is the power of TMS Web Core. Coexist with the components, so you can get the best of both worlds, HTML and dynamic components. Okay, thank you.